Nutrition and physical activity is going to go along together for our bodies. Exercise is going to give us fitness along with four major things: flexibility, strength, muscle endurance, and cardiovascular health. Diet on its own is not going to be able to give you this. You need to have the physical part as well. One thing to remember is that a bad diet can affect the way that your fitness training goes, even if you follow the best type of exercise plan that you can. You need to put a healthy diet and a lot of exercise together to stay as healthy as you can. It is going to be achievable to answer the question of how long you need to exercise to keep as healthy as you can. The average is at least 20 minutes of exercise at least 3 times a week. This will help to strengthen the cardiovascular health. Another idea is that 3,500 calories must be used in a week by doing any sort of physical activity. This will benefit you and your heart as well. It is a good idea to speak to your doctor first to find out what exercise plan is going to be best for you and your body. The energy nutrients that are stored, like glucose and fatty acids with a few amino acids, are let out into the blood during exercise in order to provide energy for what you are doing. This means that the body will respond to exercise by adjusting its fuel amounts. There is a way to use diet to control high blood pressure, and now they are finding out that exercise has a role in keeping blood pressure from increasing. With the reduction of sodium into your body, weight loss and limited alcohol use, along with the increased amount of physical activity and a low-fat diet, you can control hypertension. Foods that are used for the purpose of lowering blood pressure without using medication can include sweets and many beverages that have sugar in them, red meat and fats. To build muscle in the body, proteins are used, and this is true when the body is at rest after exercise or any type of physical activity. There is research that has shown that athletes will retain more protein and use more of it as fuel for the body. The American Dietetic Association has said that 1 gram per kilogram of body weight is recommended for people that do not exercise at all. For the athletes, the protein amounts are going to be higher. It should be considered that athletes also need more carbohydrates as well. If they do not take in enough carbs, their protein will be used all up for fuel, and there will not be anything left for muscle building after exercise is done. There is increasing evidence that weight-bearing exercises like walking, dancing, running, sports and so much more are very good at getting good bone health. Swimming has been a great use for bone health. Eating disorders like bulimia and anorexia have been said to damage bone strength. Exercise alone cannot make your body healthy. You need to have the proper calcium and other vitamins and minerals required for bones must go with the adequate amount of exercise to provide the best bone health. Along with exercise, diet can help keep your body working good and in the right mode for the rest of your life.